and welcome to an episode that deals with photo editing and its various genres. I'm Yamini Sethi and our subject expert is Kumar Bharun. He's a veteran photographer with 7 years of experience in photography, graphic designing and photojournalism, and currently working as a senior photographer with fabfashion.com. Let us look at what we will attempt to do today. First, to learn the usage of editing. Second, to learn about the various softwares of editing. Third, to understand the various tools of editing. And fourth, understanding the various techniques of editing still photographs. Photo editing is an art and craft of effective communication. Every photograph, even once edited, looks like a masterpiece, but at the same time, photo editing is a painstaking and creative job, which requires both skill and knowledge of the various tools to be employed to give the raw picture a final touch.
Photo editing becomes a very important aspect in this era of digital photography. We can't think of a digital photography without doing photo editing on it. In earlier days, we used to do all the editing by using chemical method, going to the dark room, processing the film, and also enlarging, cropping, dodging, burning, lot of effects we can put by in earlier days by going to a dark room, by processing the photographs in dark room. In today's day, the computer becomes our darkroom and we have several programs to manipulate images and correct them for any flaws. Digitally, in earlier days when digital photography was beginning, even in those nascent stages, we started naming film formats like digital negatives. We started naming certain program as digital darkroom. And nowadays, because it has taken such an important aspect that nobody can even think of taking pictures without trying to edit it or without going to some program to edit it, resize it. Even for an amateur, it's important to resize your images to send it on the email or to match it with an output device for your mobile, or if you want to display it on some other place or you want to give it for printing. So I can't emphasize more that editing becomes a very important aspect of taking picture. You should devote at least 50% of time as you take on editing, the time you spend on taking picture, at least 50% of it need to be taken for editing those pictures. So editing is the foremost important aspect for any digital photographer.
Techniques for photo editing. First, selection. Selecting objects and tools for editing. Second, cropping. Cropping picture or area. Third, enlarging, blowing up, increasing the size of an image. Next is reducing. Reducing the pixels or the size of the image. And the next one is sizing, giving the correct size or the shape to an object or a picture. Next one is retouching, working on a given picture in order to correct the deformities. And the next one, reproduction, to produce again an effect. The major editing programs used for editing are Adobe Photoshop, Corel Paint Shop, Picasa, Photoscape, GIMP, Serif Photo Plus, Yara Photo Designer, ULED Photo Impact, and Photo Impression.
There are several programs which we talked about in this program, but the gold standard or the best software for any photo editing remain two. One is a proprietary software, which is Photoshop, The other one is GIMP, which is a free software. Both of them can be used for amateur photographer and also by advanced photographer. You can have several effect. You can automate, you can resize, you can layer picture with other elements and do any kind of processing or of your photos, which can include cropping, framing, editing, and changing color balance, making soft and hard images from your photographs. As we have emphasized that photo editing is a very important part of any digital photography, there are certain steps which need to be taken before we output the pictures or we send it for any use. First of all, we reframe our subject by cropping it, by rotating it, and by changing any keystone defect which it has. The second thing is changing contrast, brightness, exposure, etc. on the picture. The third is that you need to be making the picture a little sharper or softer depending on the subject which is included in the picture. The fourth one is color correction. We do an overall color correction. We can change a little tint or give it a little tone, and overall color balance need to be tweaked. Another aspect would to reduce noise. All the digital photography on all the digital cameras would produce some amount of noise, especially if they are taken in low light conditions. So if we find there is noise, we need to reduce the noise in the picture by using certain techniques, image editing techniques. The last one is that we control aberration which are produced by lenses, which include peripheral dimming of the images, which we call as vignetting. We also can correct chromatic aberration, which is produced with certain lenses, especially tele lenses. And in the end, we need to resize our image to suit any output use. If we are sending it by email, it need to have a smaller size. If we want to give it for printing, it need to have a bigger size. So in the end, we resize image. So these are at least some of the important steps which we take before we edit pictures. An advanced photographer would employ certain more techniques, but at least for me, these techniques are essential.
Now we shall take a look at various elements and understand its working and usage. Selection stands out as the primary and the most important function. In fact, one of the prerequisites for many of the applications mentioned below is a method of selecting parts of an image and thus applying the change selectively without affecting the entire picture. Most of the graphic programs have several means of accomplishing this, such as a marquee tool for selecting polygon shapes, a lasso tool for freehand selection of a region, a magic wand tool that selects objects or region in the image defined by proximity of color or luminance, vector-based tools. There are also some more advanced facilities such as edge detection, masking, alpha compositing and color, channel-based extraction. The border of a selected area in an image is often animated with the marching ants effect to help the user to distinguish the selection border from the image background. Another feature common to many graphic applications is that of layers. Layers are analogous to sheets of transparent acetate, each containing separate elements that make up a combined picture. Stacked on the top of each other, each capable of being individually positioned, altered, and blended with the layers below, without affecting any of the elements on the other layers. This is a fundamental workflow which has become the norm for the majority of the programs in the market today and enables maximum flexibility for the user while maintaining non-destructive editing principles and ease of use. Image editors can resize images in a process often called image scaling, making them larger or smaller. High image resolution cameras can produce large images which are often reduced in size for internet use. Image editor programs use a mathematical process called resampling to calculate new pixel values whose spacing is larger or smaller than the original pixel values. Images for internet use are kept small, say 640 by 480 pixels, which would equal to 0.3 megapixels. Digital editors are used to crop images. Cropping creates a new image by selecting a desired rectangular portion from the image being cropped. The unwanted part of the image is discarded. Image cropping does not reduce the resolution of the area cropped. Best results are obtained when the original image has high resolution. A primary reason for cropping is to improve the image composition in the new image. Image editors have provisions to create an image histogram of the image being edited. The histogram plots the number of pixels in the image, vertical axis, with a particular brightness value, that is horizontal axis. Algorithms in the digital editor allows the user to visually adjust the brightness value of each pixel and to dynamically display the results as adjustments are made. Improvements in picture brightness and contrast can thus be obtained. Image editors may feature a number of algorithms which can add or remove noise in an image. Some JPEG artifacts can be removed, dust and scratches can be removed, and an image can be despeckled. Noise reduction merely estimates the state of the scenes without the noise and is not a substitute for obtaining a cleaner image. Excessive noise reduction leads to a loss of detail, and its application is hence subject to a trade-off between the undesirability of the noise itself and that of the reduction artifacts. Noise tends to invade images when pictures are taken in low light settings. A new picture can be given an antiquated effect by adding uniform monochrome noise. Most image editors can be used to remove unwanted branches, etc., using a clone tool. Removing these distracted elements draws focus to the subject, improving overall composition. Some image editors have color swapping abilities to selectively change the color of the specific items in an image, given that the selected items are within a specific color range. Image editors are capable of altering an image to be rotated in any direction and to any degree. Mirror images can be created and images can be horizontally flipped or vertically flop. A small rotation of several degrees is often enough to level the horizon, correct verticality of a building, for example, or both. Rotated image usually requires cropping afterwards in order to remove the resulting gaps at the image edges. Some image editors allow the user to distort or transform the shape of an image. While this might also be useful for special effects, it is the preferred method of correcting the typical perspective distortion which results from photographs being taken at an oblique angle to a rectilinear subject. Care is needed while performing this task as the image is reprocessed using the interpolation of adjacent pixels, which may reduce overall image definition. The effect mimics the use of perspective control lens, which achieves a similar correction in camera without loss of definition. Photo manipulation packages have functions to correct images for various lens distortions, including pin cushion, fisheye, and barrel distortions. The corrections are in most cases subtle, but can improve the appearance of some photographs. In computer graphics, the process of improving the quality of a digitally stored image by manipulating the image with software. It is quite easy, for example, to make an image lighter or darker or to increase or decrease contrast. Advanced photo enhancement software also supports many filters for altering images in various ways. Programs specialized for image enhancements are sometimes called image editors. Graphics programs can be used to both sharpen and blur images in a number of ways, such as unsharp masking or deconvolution. Portraits often appear more pleasing when selectively softened, particularly the skin and the background, to better make the subject stand out. This can be achieved with a camera by using a large aperture or in the image editor by making a selection and then blurring it. Edge enhancement is an extremely common technique used to make images appear sharper, although purists frown on the result as appearing unnatural. Many graphic applications are capable of merging one or more individual images into a single file. The orientation and placement of each image can be controlled. When selecting a raster image that is not rectangular, it requires separating the edges from the background, also known as silhouetting. It's a digital part of cutting out images. Clipping paths may be used to add silhouetted images to vector graphics or page layout files that retain vector data. Alpha compositing allows for soft translucent edges when selecting images. There are a number of ways to silhouette an image with soft edges, including selecting the image or its background by sampling similar colors, selecting the edges by raster tracing, or converting a clipping path to a raster selection. Once the image is selected, it may be copied and pasted into another section of the same file or into a separate file. The selection may also be saved in what is known as an alpha channel. The popular way to create a composite image is to use transparent layers. The background image is used as the bottom layer, and the image with parts to be added are placed in the layer above that. Using an image layer mask, all but the parts to be merged are hidden from the layer, giving the impression that these parts have been added to the background layer. Performing a merge in this manner preserves all of the pixel data on both layers to more easily enable future changes in the new merged image. A more recent tool in digital image editing software is the image slicer. Part of images for graphical user interfaces or web pages are easily sliced, labeled, and saved separately from the whole images, so that the parts can be handled individually by the display medium. This is useful to allow dynamic swapping via interactivity or animating parts of an image in the final presentation. Image editors usually have a list of special effects that can create unusual results. Images may be skewed and distorted in various ways. Scores of special effects can be applied to an image, which includes various forms of distortion artistic effects, geometric transforms, and texture effects or combinations thereof. It is possible using software to change the color depth of the images. Common color depths are 2, 4, 16, 256, 65, 536, and 16.7 million colors. The JPEG and PNG image formats are capable of storing 16.7 million colors, equals to 256 luminance values per color channel. In addition, grayscale images of 8 bits or less can be created, usually via conversion and downsampling from a full color image. Grayscale conversion is useful for reducing file size dramatically when the original photographic print was monochrome, but a color tint has been introduced due to aging effects. Image editors have provisions to simultaneously change the contrast of images and brighten or darken the image. Underexposed images can be often improved by using this feature. Recent advances have allowed more intelligent exposure correction, whereby only pixels below a particular luminosity threshold are brightened, and thereby brightening underexposed shadows without affecting the rest of the image. The exact transformation that is applied to each color channel can vary from editor to editor. GIMP applies this formula. Where the value is the input color value in the 0 to 1 range and the brightness and contrast are in minus 1 to 1 range. In addition to the capability of changing the images, brightness or contrast in a non-linear fashion, most current image editors provide an opportunity to manipulate the image's gamma value. Gamma correction is particularly useful for bringing details that would be hard to see on most computer monitors out of shadows. In some image editing software, this is called curves, usually a tool found in the color menu, and no reference to gamma is used anywhere in the program or program documentation. Strictly speaking, the curves tools usually does more than simple gamma correction, since one can construct complex curves with multiple inflection points, but when no dedicated gamma correction tool is provided, it can achieve the same effect. The color of images can be altered in a variety of ways. Colors can be faded in and out, and tones can be changed using curves or other tools. The color balance can be improved, which is important if the picture was shot indoors and daylight film, or shot on a camera with the white balance incorrectly set. Special effects like sepia and grayscale can be added to an image. In addition, more complicated procedures such as mixing of a color channels are possible using more advanced graphic editors. The red eye effect, which occurs when flash photos are taken when the pupil is too widely open, so that the light from the flash that passes into the eye through the pupil reflects off the fundus at the back of the eyeball, can also be eliminated at this stage.
Photo does not lose its originality when edited in normal editing programs. You have option that you want to change originality or you don't want to change originality. As far as the question of originality is concerned, people think that changing global overall correction changes its originality. It does not. We should understand that in the camera, the sensors, which still are analog till date, produce a very bad quality image. It's a very low contrast, fuzzy, unsharp image which sensor in any digital camera produce. Now within camera there is a lot of processing which takes place. You color balance it, the camera program sharpens it, it does lot of image editing happens inside the camera. So unless this image editing is done, the photo or the picture remain unusable. So the camera itself does lot of processing, and there are a lot of image processing engines and other thing inside the camera. When we take a picture and it comes to my computer, then also I can edit it without losing its originality. For instance, if I do an overall change, for instance, I change color balance, I change sharpness, I change contrast, I change gamma, I can change overall anything, I crop, I can, all these effects, if done overall, does not make the image as if you manipulated it. It would remain as an original image.
Controlling the print size and quality of digital images requires an understanding of pixels per inch, that is PPI, variable that is stored in the image file and sometimes used to control the size of the printed image. Within Adobe Photoshop's image size dialog, the image editor allows the user to manipulate both pixel dimensions and the size of the image on the printed document. These parameters work together to produce a printed image of the desired size and quality. Pixels per inch of the image, pixels per inch of the computer monitor, and the dots per inch on the printed document are related, but in use are very different. The image size dialog can be used as an image calculator of sorts. For example, a 1600 by 1200 image with a resolution of 200 ppi will produce a printed image of 8 by 6 inches. The same image with 400 ppi will produce a printed image of 4 by 3 inches, and change resolution of 800 ppi and the same image now prints out at 2 into 1.5 inches. All three printed images contain the same data, 1600 by 1200 pixels, but the pixels are closer together on the smaller prints, so the smaller images will potentially look sharp when the larger ones do not. The quality of the image will also depend on the capability of the printer. Photo editing is most essential as well as the most important process required to create perfect pictures. With new and improved techniques and software for editing, photography has explored new dimensions of perfection. Varied backgrounds, change of location, airbrushing, etc. create interesting pictures and creative works of photography. Selection, cropping, sizing, enlarging, retouching are the tools applied to correct and improve images. This is all for today. I hope you have enjoyed the lecture. Thank you and goodbye.